I'm not seditious, you are. Clearly, sedition is on the tip of every pundit's tongue. So today, we're quickly unwrapping the history of the Sedition Act of 1798. In 1798, the House passed the Sedition Act, which gave the U.S. government the go-ahead to deport, fine, or imprison anyone deemed a threat to or who was caught publishing false or malicious writing against the government. The Fifth Congress narrowly passed it, with the majority Federalists voting 44 in favor, while the minority Jeffersonian Republicans voting 41 against. Not that Republican Party. Basically, the Federalists were motivated by fear of war with France, and let's be honest, they were scared to lose power too. The Republicans, led by James Madison, had a fit though, because they felt it was a clear violation of the First Amendment. Sound familiar? Nonetheless, John Adams signed it into law on July 14th. Game over, right? Wrong. The act proved wildly unpopular and was one of the defining reasons Adams lost his re-election to Thomas Jefferson in 1800. The act expired in 1801, and it's been hotly debated ever since. To learn more about current laws around sedition and how that plays a role in your life, check out our other videos, go to commonally.com, and download the Common Ally app.